The greatest YouTuber you've never heard of presents the greatest talk show you've never heard of, Talks with Taste, featuring your host, Taste Champagne, and today's guest, Thabo Ndawonde.
Hi, welcome back. What's good? Welcome back to Taste TV. And this time around, we're doing something very special. We're doing a segment called Talks with Taste. And today we're joined by the CEO of Grubs of Thabs himself, Thabo Ndawonde. Say hi to the people, sir.
Yo, what it do, man? What it do, y'all?
How are you?
I'm good, bro.
You want to tell us a little bit about what it is exactly that you do and how you got into it? Just a little background. 411.
Yo, I've loved food since the beginning, man. I've always known, but you know, I've been skeptical.
Skeptical about loving food.
Nah, but actually following it as a career. Right now, I cater for small events, mainly because I want to be on hands-on with everything that I produce, so quality control, you know. With Grubs and Thabs, I do small events, literally just trying to put out my food, spread some love, man, and, you know, make people happy.
Well, tell us a little bit about what we're going to be making, sir.
So, we're going to be making a fettuccine pasta.
Okay.
Right? So the story behind this fettuccine pasta is that the mine workers used to make it with like salt cured bacon. So that's where it comes from.
Yeah.
It was made with an egg sauce also, which I'm going to get, but with a twist, because it's meat, you know. And then I'm going to add some chicken breast to it just to add some protein to it. And we're just going to play around with some ingredients, see how it goes.
So Grubs with Thabs.
Cool, man.
Interesting choice. If I do say so myself, how did that name come about? Like, what made you sit down and be like, this is what we're going with?
I think for me, it was like, try to find something that people can relate to, you know? And also, a lot of people don't know that Grubs means food.
Who?
You know, it's slang for food. you know, I've had to educate a lot of people that Grubs with Thabs actually means foods with Thabs. Some people actually say Grabs with Thabs. I thought about changing that name, yo. But hey, Grubs with Thabs, man. It rhymes, and I think white people, it makes it easier to say my name also, you know? So I'm gonna teach you guys how to hold a knife, because a lot of you guys don't know how to hold a knife. That's how we make accidents, right? So make sure your knife is comfortable, you know? Hold it however you want. You're gonna hold your knife in a comfortable way. This is how I prefer to hold it, right? You're gonna tuck in your fingertips. The knife is gonna go along your nails. You can't possibly cut your nails. So no matter how quick you go, you can never make a mistake, ever.
So being on the technical side of culinary arts and culinary science, do you ever like have your girlfriend or your mom or someone make you a really good meal,
bro,
that they think is good and you're like, it's really?
So you know these hands don't want me, bro. A lot of people have stopped cooking for me because of what I do now. And I really don't mind trying new foods and people cooking for me, as long as the dish shows some of you inside of it, man, that's cool.
So what do you say though once the food comes and it's, are you like, babe, like, I love you, babe.
I love you. If they ask for my advice, I give it.
Oh, okay.
But otherwise I keep quiet and like, I just shove it down and I keep going, man. That's how we keep going in this house. I've had to deal with a lot lately. We'd rather not talk about that because I still want to get invited to people's houses. What's the worst meal you've had, actually? Like, in terms of
cooked by someone else? Like, by like a girl or someone?
Yeah.
The worst.
What you've made, actually.
Yeah. So this one night I was cooking and all of a sudden, my nose clogs up, my throat closes. Have you ever seen the movie Hitch?
Oh yeah!
And it gets like that. My lips look like airbags.
Bro,
it was crazy, man. That was crazy. I was making couscous with pepper dews and then like some chicken with a little bit of pepper as well.
Hey,
I don't know what
can cook, apparently, yo. I don't even know why we're tutoring with you. You don't need me.
I can cook what I eat, you know? So I'm like, I'm a level way below you, but like, I'm there.
How's the chicken breast going, bro?
It's going good. I mean, you're the person that's gonna look at it and decide. But I actually wanted to ask, what's a simple dish that people always up and how?
Toasted cheese sandwiches, yo. Like, I can't, yo. Guys.
What's the correct way to make a toasted cheese?
Please butter your bread on the outside. Even if it's going in the oven, it's going on the pan. Butter your bread on the outside. And then, for some extra flavor, garlic, like complete. Put your cheese, 3 cheeses, 4 cheeses, all the cheese you want. You know, make sure you're not lactose intolerant. Add that cheese until it melts on the outside and just drips out, bro. Oh,
dude, I can hardly afford one cheese at a time to add 3 different cheeses. Do you know, that's why me and my brother got divorced. We used to do groceries together and then we decided. Because he was paying like 85 rand a week for cheese. So I sat down and I crunched numbers. I was like, 85 rand a week for cheese.
This thing is holding me down.
That's 320 a month for cheese. I'm not even ingredients. They say everyone should keep in their kitchen.
Bro, I don't know where my garlic is, but garlic, like, guys, if I could take that thing in my backpack, everywhere I go, garlic is a go-to. Herbs, guys, wow, herbs. And a lot of people think herbs, like, you can put herbs in anything, it keeps the dish interesting, it gives it that freshness also. I think salt and pepper and butter also, wow, guys, that combo is lethal.
Do you ever think it gets a little pretentious with the herbs though? Like, you know, sometimes I go to a restaurant and they'll be like, oh, this is a rosemary infused steak, and I'm like, I don't know who the rosemary is and how she tastes.
I think it's also a thing of like knowing what you want. Mm. If you know what you want and you get there and it's not what you wanted, then you can be like, okay, it's pretentious.
Oh, okay.
But if you're already looking for the rosemary notes and they tell you it's there, I think it makes that just that much more interesting. I get where you're coming from.
You know, the knife is the Beyonce of all the tools in the kitchen.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it sometimes even makes debuts outside the kitchen. A lot of us know we've lost belongings to it. But yeah. So yeah. Having been exposed to a lot of technical tools, I'm sure, in your culinary endeavors, what do you think is the unsung hero of kitchen tools?
Oh, man. I think my go-to has to be this thing right here, man. You know, this thing right here.
What is this thing called?
It's a whisk, man. Oh, okay. It's a whisk, yo. Yo, guys, a whisk. It does so much more than what a fork can do. You know, this incorporates air into your sauces, your sauces, your. It makes foams. It's bro, for baking especially, it adds that much, it makes everything much more fluffier and just much more lighter. I think this guy doesn't get enough recognition.
So since you were talking about go-tos just now, you know, sometimes as a student you find yourself hungry and you want to eat a really nice meal, but you've got a limited budget, limited equipment that you're working with. What would you say is like the go-to dish if you do want to treat yourself? Ooh, you know, just a little...
You know, after an exam, I get what you guys are going through, man. I think for me, it would have to be like a spaghetti bolognese. You can't go wrong with that. Like, it's just mince, it's a spaghetti, and your seasoning, man. It's really what you make it. You can take it from a simple dish where it's a quick half an hour dish. I need to eat, I need to be out the house, to a 2-hour meal. And you zhuzh that thing up, man. You make it fine dining, 5-star restaurant type quality.
Yeah, because it seems like it's got levels. It seems like it's one of those things that's really simple, but you can take it to a whole nother level.
Definitely. Yeah.
So since now you're officially in it, like you are in the whole chef thing.
Yeah, man.
What do you feel like you were doing wrong before? Ooh. Now that you've learned like the proper ways.
Where do I start doing? With how. Again, I think I view food a lot more differently now because I've learned the scientific aspect of everything also, and how everything is supposed to come together, the melting pot of flavors and how we do everything. For me, number one, I used to burn my onions. Yo, guys, I used to burn my onions. I never used to know the consistency of sauces. I never used to know that you can't mix milk with acids like lemons.
So like, seeing as you're now in the technical side and you see a lot of the behind the scenes, I'm sure the whole restaurant going experience has changed for you. What dish do you feel like just doesn't get justice on restaurant menus?
Ooh. Oh man, that's a tough one. I think steaks. I can't count the amount of times I've gone to a restaurant, ordered a steak and asked for it to be meat. And people have not nailed that medium. And they assume because I'm black, I don't like my meat, like, with a little color, you know? They're like, no, man, come on.
So you're scaling up a small business right now, Grubs with Thabs. Cool. That's your primary focus. That's What's the end goal career-wise for you as a culinary activist?
There's a lot that I want to do, man. Opening up awareness shelters for food.
Like nutrition?
Yeah, nutrition definitely also. I think that's something I really want to look into. Mm. And for me, I want to own a farm restaurant. And in that, I'm saying, I want you to arrive at the farm, you see where the food is grown, and you see the kitchens, and everything is just transparent, and everyone can see what's actually going on, that the food is healthy, it's grown on site, it's organic, it's what you're paying for, basically. And I think that, for me, would be the ultimate end goal, because I could go on for days about the visions, and I want to be a restaurant aesthetist. I want to design cutlery, man. I want to design plates. There's so much I want to do.
I'm sure, like, since you know the ins and outs of food now, there's certain things that people just can't appreciate. The average man can't appreciate.
Cool.
So when you make a dish for an unhappy client or customer, or even a loved one, how do you deal with their unhappiness? Do you start rethinking recipes, rethinking processes, or do you just shrug it off as if they're just gonna have the taste for it?
Okay, to some extent, now I think I've learned enough to kind of be, I don't want to say narcissistic, but to be cocky in the way I cook. So I work on things and I try to find common ground where people agree on certain things and what they like. And that's how, for me, I think you grow as a chef.
You're doing great so far. It smells great, honestly. Cool. It looks great.
Thanks,
I don't know. Obviously, you can't really smell it, but you can see it. Sometimes you do understand, since it's an art and it's a science, and it's just like there's so many different levels.
Ooh.
I just caught like a whiff of the smoke. So yeah, sometimes maybe you feel like people are not of the mental capacity or like the palate or the taste to appreciate what you're throwing them. How do you bring them into the light? How do you really make them be able to appreciate? How do you educate them?
The more they expose to new things, I think that also just expands their taste palates and just how they recognize and how they interact with their food, basically. And I think it grows. New things make you grow as a person. You start to taste things differently. You start to recognize new ingredients. Like, oh, okay, I haven't tasted this before. This is really interesting. I don't like that. I like this. Mm. You start differentiating between things you like and don't like. I think that's the first stage to anything, really.
What's that one dish that you were like, I didn't know people could make this good?
I'm a slut for pasta. Like, yo, guys. A gift from the gods, honestly. Alright, I've been looking forward to this moment literally the whole day.
You've seen Grubs with Thabs, be sure to check it out on the gram, check it out as well on Twitter. Are you on Twitter?
Yeah, at Thabo Ndawonde.
Cool. And as a bonus, you get to sit and watch us eat dessert. So it's gonna turn into an ASMR clip just now. We're gonna be chilling stuff.
How are you doing? It's been kind of good, actually. Woke up this morning, took a shower, started making you guys.